we got to like actually pretend like we were part of the police department.
This experiment, it was really fun to just learn about the different steps that it takes to solve a crime scene with like the fingerprinting and the DNA and the blood samples. That was really interesting.
This project started a few years ago as a way for students to apply what their genetics knowledge is to a scenario. We had this young boy who was kidnapped, and we wanted to use some genetics to try to figure out, did his father kidnap him, or is there some other unknown father that we didn't know about? And last year, when Officer Adam Fulkerson came in and knew about our project, he said, hey, why don't we bring in an actual, you know, fake crime, have the students see what the crime is all about, and then tie it into our genetics review.
They have a whole scenario that they have been doing for years, and I thought, well, if we could kind of recreate that, but also show how we collect evidence, what we're looking for, that kind of thing. We could really bring this to life for the students, and hopefully they get something out of it and just see something different in this unit than just looking at paper in the classroom.
It's basically a mystery that we have to solve, and the things that we need to solve it, the math, the physics, the biology, all that they're learning in school now could someday play into what they do in the future.
One of the most important things in the next generation science standards is to give the students authentic, real life types of evidence or scenarios where they could actually apply what they're learning in science to more of a hands-on or project-based type of learning.
I thought it was pretty cool because what I'm used to in class is like giving like a worksheet or something, but to get actually hands-on with something like that, it's cool to like have the different tools and different things that we're not used to in class and hands-on lab like that.
A lot of people are more visual learners and they like, you know, hands-on projects where they can actually like hold something, they can think through something, they can like actually go through the process themselves.